She was just such a bubbly person. She didn't have a bad bone in her body. All she ever wanted to do was make people smile.
I think she was generous to a fault. She would always put others before herself.
Ruhela was this one in a million type people. She just had a natural warmth that would penetrate anyone.
The family of radio presenter Ruhela Adatia Sood sit together and reminisce, but with heavy hearts. Ruhela's life and that of her unborn baby were cut short during the Westgate terror attack on September 21st, 2013. And for her family, it's been a hard year without her.
Just the most amazing person, just the most compassionate, amazing person who deserves to still be here.
She brought into the house laughter, love, sunshine, so much happiness.
That smiley face, we want it there all the time. I mean, we want it there forever.
I think it's been a bit of, well, a lot of kind of pretending it away, kind of pretending it didn't really happen.
But despite the harsh reality, Ruhela's family is determined to keep her spirit alive through her love for animals. Her husband, Ketan, with the help of friends, has set up RASAST, the Ruhela Adatia Sood Animal Support Trust. Its aim is to support the welfare of animals, and its main target is the KSPCA.
Very close to our house, there's a road that my dad used to pass. And he mentioned to us one day that he saw a couple of malnutrition dogs, a few puppies running around there. And Ruhela, being Ruhela, said, look, we need to do something about this. So Ruhela started every single day going and feeding them at great personal risk to herself, because that area is quite dangerous. She'd go there with food, feed them every day. She'd always come back with a story of somebody threatening her. And I was like, Ruhela, what's going on? She's like, I love animals.
Can you imagine the Ketan and her, they went to Thika, they found out that somebody's mistreating some dogs and selling them. They went all the way to some small village in Thika. They actually bought those dogs. They bought six dogs, got them vaccinated and got them adopted.
I think Ruhela embodied everything that a good human being would like to be. She was selfless.
The week before her untimely demise, we were actually on our way to KSPCA to have a meeting, because what we wanted to do was just, you know, see how we can help them. We were told that the KSPCA is really struggling to raise funds, raise awareness. And so the week before she passed away, we said, let's go to the KSPCA and see what we can do. Unfortunately, we never made it because of Nairobi traffic. She passed away the week after that. And so what better way to keep her name going than through this trust?
RASAST was launched on August the 30th, a day after what would have been Ruhela's 33rd birthday. 1.2 million shillings was raised.
The week before the trust, we were actually struggling to sell tickets. And suddenly, we were out of tickets. We were completely sold out. There were so many people there that I didn't know that had heard about the launch that came. And they were like, you know, whatever you need, please let us know. We're willing to help.
We hope to do something again next year to help keep keep helping the welfare and protection of animals, but also to keep her memory alive as well, and do something that was close to her heart.
If we can save some lives of some animals through her name, then I'll say that she hasn't died in vain. Then I'll say she hasn't died in vain. That's how I want it to be remembered.
Smriti Vidyarthi Mohindra, NTV.